सरस्वती शिशुकुंज ओगवाला बोरसद वेलकम्स यू स्टैंडर्ड 9 सब्जेक्ट मैथमेटिक्स चैप्टर नंबर 5 इंट्रोडक्शन टू यूक्लिड्स ज्योमेट्री। फ्रेंड्स, इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड यूक्लिड्स एक्सियोम्स एंड यूक्लिड्स पोस्टुलेट्स। ओके, नाउ ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ एक्सियोम्स एंड पोस्टुलेट्स लेट अस डिस्कस द क्वेश्चंस। द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स आर ट्रू और फॉल्स। Whenever your statement is false, you need to write the reason why the statement is false. Okay? So, the first one is only one line can passes through a single point. Friends, for this statement, can I draw a line? This is one line. On passing through one point, this is another line. This is third one, this is fourth one. So, from this figure we can say that there are infinitely many lines passes through a single point. So, this statement is false. So, we can write here false. And what is the reason? The reason is because there are infinitely many lines pass through a single point. Okay, so this is the first question. Let us see the another one. There are infinite number of lines which passes through two distinct points. Friends, remember the postulate number 2. We know that whenever we have two distinct points, there is a unique line passes through the two distinct points. So, let us see, these are two distinct points. Now, I want to pass one single line. So, like this. Now, you cannot another line draw on two distinct points. So, our question is, there are infinite number of lines. Here we have to draw only one unique line. So, the given statement is false. Okay, the reason is there is only unique line which passes through two distinct points. Here you also write the postulate number 2. So let us see another questions of the following statements are true or false. Let us see third one. Another question is, we have to show that the statement is true or false. A terminated line can be produced indefinitely on both sides. So, friends, remember the postulate number 2. The postulate number 2 is a terminated line can be produced indefinitely. That means this is my terminated line. Okay. Now, on this side, infinite, I will be produced. On this side, also, I produce the line infinite. This is the terminated line. So this statement is true according to postulate 2. Fourth one is, if two circles are equal, then their radius are equal. Friends, two circles are radius means this is the one circle, this is. Whenever we have given that if two circles are equal, then their circle are equal. If two circles are equal, then their circumference. This is the circumference. Also are equal. If circumference are equal, the diameter also equal. and if diameter are both circle have a diameter equal, then the radius is also equal. So here we have given that this is also true. This one, if two circles are equal, then their radius are equal. It is also true. So friends, here we have discussed that two circles are equal. Once again, let us repeat. Circles are equal means their circumference are equal. Whenever their circumference are equal, the area, the point to circle, the diameter are equal on both circles. If diameter is equal, then automatically radius is equal. So if two circles are equal, then their radius are equal is true. Now let us the last question of true false sentence. The last one is, we have to check that the false given statement is true or not. In the given figure, here we have given the figure, line segment AB, line segment PQ and line segment XY. And on the according to Euclid, we can say that terminated line AB, terminated line PQ, terminated line XY. If AB equal to PQ, then AB equal to PQ and PQ equal to XY, then AB equal to XY. Now friends, remember the axiom 1. What is the axiom 1? Axiom 1 is tell that things which are equal, things which are equal to the same thing, things which are equal to the same thing are equal to one another. This is our axiom 1. Now see this question and see this axiom 1. Things which are equal to the same thing, AB equal to PQ and PQ equal to XY. So I can write here PQ equal to AB and PQ equal to XY. So things are equal to the same thing, are equal to one another, then we can write AB equal to XY. So here we have to given that same sentence. In the given figure, AB equal to PQ and PQ equal to XY, then AB equal to XY. So here we get AB equal to XY. So given statement is true. Okay, so these 5 statements, we have to check the statements are true or false. It can be asked in your exam also. So this is the question, true false type question. Now let us move further and write the definition of some concepts. Let us discuss some definitions. First one is parallel lines. What are the parallel lines? The parallel lines, two lines are lies on the same plane. Same plane and do not intersect. Do not intersect each other is called parallel line. For example, these two lines, see, these two lines are on same plane. Here this is the plane. This is the plane alpha, the line L and line M. So this line, whenever this go infinitely times, this side the line will go infinitely, but two lines never intersect. Whenever, like a railway cross, railway lines never intersect. So these two lines are called parallel lines. Second one is perpendicular line. Perpendicular lines. So here we have to talking about two lines. So two lines are lies on same plane and intersect to each other and make right angle means 90 degree angle is called perpendicular line. For example, see this line. So this is 90 degree, this. So these two lines are called perpendicular line. Now let us see third definition. The third one is line segment. Line segment, in other words, we can say terminated line. Terminated line. So line segment is a line with two end point is called line segment, like this A and B. So these two are end points, A and B. So this is called a terminated line, as well as we can say that this is the line segment. We can write like this one, A, B, line segment A. Now let us see fourth definition. Radius of a circle means any line segment. First of all, for radius of a circle, we have to draw one circle. This is the center. Now, what is the radius of circle? Any line segment joining the center of a circle. That means center of a circle to any point on its circumference. Any point on its circumference. So here, so this is the radius. This is also we can say the radius. So the radius of a circle is nothing but any line segment joining the center of a circle to any point on its circumference is called radius of a circle. Next one we can say, take square. Square means a quadrilateral with four same sides and equal angle, all angles are 90 degree, is called square, like this one. The length of four sides are equal and four angles are same, that means these are 90 degree, A, B, C, D. So this is called a square. Once again, a quadrilateral with four same sides or a four same length of their sides and equal angle. Equal angles means all angles are equal, 90, 90, 90, 90. So this is called a square. Next is center of a circle. Center of a circle means a point in the plane of a circle which is equidistant from all points of a circle. See, here this distance is equal, this is the same, this is the same. So this point is called center of a circle. This distance from any points from the circle is equal, that means this point is called center of a circle. Next one is right angle, an angle of 90 degree. We can say that an angle of 90 degree is called right angle. And last one, circumference. circumference. The boundary of a circle. The boundary of a circle is called the length. Sorry, the length of the boundary of the circle. Length of the boundary of the circle is called circumference. That means you have to measure this boundary, length of boundary. See, this is the called circumference of the circle. So friends, these are some important definitions of some concept. We have seen the center of a circle, radius of a circle, circumference, square, line segment, parallel lines, perpendicular lines. So these are some concepts. Now let us see one small example we have to solve it. Let us see. Here we have to given that if a point C lies between two points A and B. So first of all, let us draw a line AB, and C lies between A and B. Here the condition is that AC equal to BC. So we can say that it is given that AC equal to BC. Now we know that equals are added to equals, axiom 2. So can I write this way? AC plus AC equal to AC plus BC. We can here write equals are added, equals are added to equals, axiom 2. Okay, now here I can write 2AC, and see AC plus BC equal to, we can say AB. So we can write 2AC equal to AB. Now we can see half of the thing is equal to another half of the thing. So we can write 1 by 2 into 2AC equal to 1 by 2 into AB. Both sides I multiply by 1 by 2. So 2, 2 will be cancelled out. The answer is AC equal to 1 by 2 AB. AC equal to 1 by 2 AB, because C is the midpoint of given line. So friends, this is the chapter number 5, Introduction to Euclid's Geometry. In this chapter, we have to discuss the postulates, axioms, some concept of definitions like square, parallel lines, perpendicular lines, and the short example. In the exam or in the unit test, you have to ask some short questions, filling the blanks, multiple choice questions, true false type questions in this chapter. So you have to compulsory prepare axioms and postulates as well as the definitions also. In this chapter, there is the question asked will be on 1 mark only. So this is for you. You have to prepare the postulates as well as axioms as well as definitions. If you have to doubt of any question, you have to contact to me. The worksheet is given by PDF. You need to write all the things: definitions, postulates, true false statements, and the short example also you have to write. There is no homework, but you need to write all the worksheet in your notebook, scan it and send it in your homework group. Thank you. Stay home, stay safe.